Good morning. As we said in the preliminary lesson, the course will focus on Siemens ISO programming, which, to be precise, we will call G-Codes from now on. In today's lesson, we will learn from the operations course, in which we extensively discussed and dealt with G-Code programming compared with SHOPMILL or SHOPTURN programming from Siemens. So for those of you who have already seen the video, because you have taken the operational course, you can go straight to the next lesson. And if you see me looking younger and with a few white hairs, I haven't done any treatment, for it's just a video of the previous course. Paolo, what are you laughing at? Yes, Paolo, you're really funny. I know I don't have much hair, but among those few hairs, there are actually some white ones. Of course, you're quick to talk. You don't age, and above all, with that quiff of yours, you're always proud of it. And you make me a little jealous, to tell the truth. Well, I'll leave you with a video on programming in G-Codes versus SHOPMILL, here on CNC, of course. First of all, let's review the procedure for creating a new part program. Let's review the steps slowly. Go to Program Manager, the position where we want to create our program, and press New. Before going any further, I'll stop right here. In fact, on this screen, if you notice, the vertical soft keys allow me to choose what I want to create. Let's see the options. We will have at the top the directory button to create a workpiece directory that has a WPD extension. Then we have the possibility to create a SHOPMILL program that will have an MPF extension. We can create an ISO program, or better to say, a program guide with G-codes. Finally, at the bottom, we have the possibility to create files different from the previous ones. That obviously will not be programmed, but they are files that allow to read or write information about work zero offset, tool tables, and much more that concerns the machine tooling and the machine status. Now let's try to understand what it means to program in SHOPMILL, or to program in Program Guide G-Codes, which for simplicity, we will call ISO. Let's take a look at an example of the two programs. This is what a program in SHOPMILL looks like, and this is a program in G-Codes. If we compare them, we immediately see how SHOPMILL is oriented towards the operation to be performed. We can see that in the first column of each line, there is a symbol indicating the operation or cycle that will be performed. If, on the other hand, we look at the ISO program, we immediately see a language designed block by block, therefore a detailed point-by-point sequence of exactly what the machine must execute in that single block. We can therefore say that SHOPMILL is operations-oriented programming, whilst the ISO program is oriented to an exact definition of what to execute block by block. Interesting question, Paolo. The choice of one language rather than another depends on various aspects. The type of machine on which the control is installed, the type of workpieces to be produced, and the operator, his previous knowledge and skills. Let's start with a machine. If we're talking about a normal turning machine with a C and Y axis, or milling cutters with 3 or 5 axes, I'd say SHOPMILL, SHOPTURN could be the best in terms of programming speed and program reliability. If we start having to program multi-turret lathes, where it is very important to synchronize the times between the turrets or multi-spindle lathes, I would say ISO programming. Talking about milling machines and multi-pallet machining centers where it is necessary to manage the work zero offset very well, I would say ISO in this case too. Boring machines, where it is more important how you get to the machining rather than the machining itself, I would say ISO programming. Let's now look at the workpiece type. If it has machining operations that can be programmed one after the other using canned cycles, and possibly using the Siemens profile editor, it is certainly more convenient and faster to program in SHOPMILL. If, on the other hand, I have to write most of the machining operations in ISO mode because they are machining operations where there are retractions for fixture skipping, customized tool paths, a lot of control activities to manage side finishing, or for those parts typical of boring machines where the path to reach the start of machining must have a very well-defined approach, for example, a head rotation at the desired position, a rotation of the frame orientation, and approaches in restricted space conditions, for all these cases, I would choose ISO. Finally, there is the operator. A lot depends on him as well. If the operator starts from scratch, and the previous considerations allow it, I would say that he will learn and be more operational faster using SHOPMILL. If the operator is used to ISO programming because he always wants to define point by point how and where to move the machine and tool, then I would recommend ISO G-codes, especially if you have a great attitude towards parametric programming. Paolo, working in one way or another is just a matter of speed and convenience, because the nice thing is that the same cycles and functions are also present in ISO programming, and that's why I think Siemens put the program guide suffix. Let's now try to create a SHOPMILL program and a G-code program to see the editing functions. So let's go back to Program Manager, go to the Workpiece directory, CNC of course, and press New. We create a SHOPMILL program and make sure the SHOPMILL option is selected. Enter the name of the program and press OK. This opens a new SHOPMILL program, and we see that it already opens with a data entry form. These data are general information that will be common to all machining operations. Among these data, we also find the definition of the graphical model for the simulation. Let's enter the data and now try to insert a face milling. Then select face milling from the milling cycles. We see that the cycle already asks for the tool and its parameters, so the cycle itself will trigger the tool change procedure if the tool is not already present on the spindle nose. Let us now try to insert a center drilling, regardless of the parameters. Then we go to the drilling cycles and select centering. We also select the tool here, set the various parameters, and then insert it. Now we enter the positions in which we are going to execute our holes. So we select a circular series and enter the parameters of the positions on the circumference and insert. We can see that the program becomes nothing more than a sequence of operations in which it is possible to insert point-to-point movements or G functions as required. Let's now try to do the same thing in ISO and, to be precise, Program Guide G-Codes. To start with, let's enter some main G functions to make sure we start in the right conditions. Let's define the work zero offset. First of all, let's enter the definition of the blank form for the graphic. So we press various blank. Here we enter the parameters of the graphical form, which in SHOPMILL are in the header form of the program. Now we are going to do the face milling. Since we are in G-code mode, we insert the selection and the tool change groups. Then we enter our cutting parameters, without forgetting D1. We approach the workpiece and enter exactly the same face milling cycle as in the SHOPMILL. So we select face milling from the milling cycles. Here the cycle does not ask me for the tool and cutting parameters, but as far as machining is concerned, the cycle is the same. We put in a few values just to try and insert. We then move on to the execution of the center drills. So we select the tool. M6, the cutting parameters, the approach, and select the cycle. Here again, we can see that the cycle parameters are the same, with the difference that here we have to define the mCall function to repeat the cycle on several positions. Let's insert. Now let's set the circular grid on which to execute the holes. We disable mCall and turn off the spindle, and we're done. Paolo, what do you think? Of course, Paolo. For what we've done now, SHOPMILL allows you to be much faster in programming. But obviously, we mustn't forget all the considerations made at the beginning about the various applications. As I told you, if your machine and your machining operations follow a fairly linear process, and you can manage programming with the use of cycles in most cases, I would say SHOPMILL. But if you want to manage mixed programming, So a bit of G-Codes, a bit of cycle, and maybe even a bit of parametric programming, then I would recommend G-Codes. So I would say that the choice is subjective, as are the considerations about the machine, the workpiece, and the operator. I can certainly say that ShopMill is fast and reliable. It allows you to concentrate exclusively on what you have to do, and it takes care of the rest. But in any case, Siemens has done a great thing by sharing the same cycles also in ISO mode. So here too you will see the very powerful profile editor with the equally powerful contour processing cycles that I like. So it's really up to you, but the most important thing is to make the choice.